Friends, as I told yesterday, I have come back with a video on what's affecting the India-Nepal relations. As you know, a couple of days back, Nepal has released an official map which showed around 335 square kilometers of India, which is under Indian control right now as Nepalese territory. And not only that, the Nepali Prime Minister, Mr. K.P. Oli, 2 days back said the lion capital of India, which is a national emblem, and the letters below that, Satyameva Jayate, whether it means Singameva Jayate, whether the lion, not what the truth which will triumph, whether the lion will triumph. He was making a pun of might is right adage. So since India think has larger power, military power, he is saying that India is trying to hegemonize the smaller neighbors like Nepal through force. So that's why he said that the lion may be right. Another statement he made last week was about the virus coming from India, the COVID-19 virus. He said that is much more dangerous than the virus coming from China, the northern neighbor of Nepal. Yes, in the last week or 10 days, the number of cases in Nepal have increased to daily 20-30 cases are coming, mostly in the Tarai region bordering India. Mainly from people who are, most of the Nepalese who are living and working in India, who are now going back because there is no jobs are available in India or spreading the disease. So he was saying that the virus sent by India is much more dangerous than the virus coming from China. So, of course, the relationship between India and Nepal has been on the downside since this new government took over in 2018. I'll come back to that later. Now, the border issue, what is known as Kalapani, is not a new issue. It's an issue which has been there since 1816. So that is more than 2 centuries ago, 200 years ago, during East India Company time. So nothing wrong in knowing a bit of history, because history of course is very, very important, because if you don't know history, history will repeat itself. Nepal under Prithvi Narayan Shah, the Gorkha king, captured the Kathmandu Valley from the Gorkha is actually name of a place in Nepal, in eastern Nepal. From there they captured the Prithvi Narayan Shah, the leader of the Gorkhas, captured Kathmandu Valley, which was called as Nepal at that time. In the middle of 18th century. So then they captured what is present day most of the valleys. Kathmandu is a valley, most of the fertile valleys in the central part of Nepal. And they also started expanding both east and west, eastwards and westwards. Briefly, that was stopped by because they also tried to invade Tibet, and Tibetan Dalai Lama then asked help from China. So the Qing dynasty emperors and force which defeated the Nepalese forces in Tibet and came up to Kathmandu. And then Nepali king accepted the overlordship of the Qing emperor in Beijing and agreed to send tribute once in 5 years. So technically they became a vassal state of China, Nepal. So once their Tibetan ambitions were curtailed, they started looking both east and west. They captured Sikkim, which was an independent territory. They captured Kumayun, they captured Garhwal, they captured even up to Kangra, the Sirmur area of what is present day Himachal Pradesh, even Shimla. So then Maharaja Pratap Singh was the king of Punjab. So he helped the king of Kangra to defeat the Nepali Gorkha forces, and they were pushed to east of Satluj. So Satluj river formed the boundary between them and then Punjab. By this time, British were expanding. Previously, they were only up to Calcutta. Now, they had an agreement with the Nawab of Awadh, and the Treaty of Allahabad came. And most of the territories in the Gangetic Plain, they captured. So British didn't like the expansionary policies of the kings of Nepal, and therefore then of course the boundary was never, the British also controlled Gorakhpur by this time, so the boundary was not fixed between the Terai region and the hills. So there are a lot of disputes were going on. So British the war took place, the Anglo Gorkha war or Anglo Nepalese war took place between 1814 to 1816, and the Nepalese who lost were forced to concede lot of areas in the Treaty of Sagauli. Sagauli is a small town right now in Bihar in East Champaran district, just to south of the very famous Raxaul border, through which most of the trade between India and Nepal take place. So Nepal geographically is part of the Indian subcontinent. It because it is below the border, as you know, the Everest, Mount Annapurna, and all the big 8,000 plus peaks are between Nepal and Tibet. So that is a natural boundary. Anything south of the middle reach, the highest range of Himalayas, is part of the Indian subcontinent. The other side, northern side, is Tibet. So the British wanted access to Tibet because they were heard about this. They've already came across this famous Pashmina wool from Kashmir. So that comes from the Tibetan antelope. So they want to have access, and that was they thought that will be a great, because East India Company is a trading company. They are always looking for new avenues of trade. So this getting access to this particular very fine chartreuse wool will give, they can make more money in the markets of England and Europe. But they didn't have any direct contact with Tibet. So that was one of the reasons. And the second political reason could be for the war with Nepal. They don't want any resurgence between any political connection between Nepal, Marathas, and Punjab, and all that. So they want to nip it in the bud. So probably all this could be because Nepal at that time prided itself as a Hindu, true Hindu nation. So whatever may be the reasons, the British defeated the Nepalese forces, Gorkha forces, and the Treaty of Sagauli was signed in 1816. So under which, on the eastern side, Sikkim and what is present day Darjeeling, Siliguri areas, which are also under the control of Nepal, were ceded to the British. And Sikkim became a protectorate of Nepal, and Darjeeling they annexed it outright. And that is on the Mechi River, became the boundary between British India and the East India Company and the Nepalese. And on the western side, they were forced to vacate all the areas west of Kali River, Kali or Mahakali River. This Mahakali River starts from the very high reaches of Himalayas, and then it is called as also Sharada River. Then it joins Ghagra River in India, and later Ghagra joins Ganga. So essentially Mahakali is a tributary of Ganges. So this Mahakali River is the boundary. It is agreed upon in Treaty of Sagauli. There is no doubt about that. But what exactly is Mahakali River is a dispute. The British felt that what is present, you might have read that is a Kalapani dispute, Kalapani black waters. So Kalapani is actually a spring from which the headwaters, some streams come, and they also became joined this Kali River. So what exactly is Kali River is a dispute there. So that is why I put this map. I'm not sure whether you can see it, because I think it is you can see it only ulta. So this is Indian side, this is Nepali side. This is on the line, on the black is the present boundary. So northern side is Tibet or China there. So this is this is Kali River. So India says, in the interpretation from the Indian side, is the river Kali starts only from this point only. Beyond that, the headwaters are not Kali River, and therefore they are not covered by this Treaty of Sagauli. So this is one easternmost river called Tinker River. This is the present boundary. These are the areas controlled by India right now. And this is the Kalapani. This is the springs from which the headwaters come there. And there is one more western river which comes, which is known as Kuthiyanti River. So this one famous Lipule Pass connecting the Indian subcontinent with Tibet is under the Indian control. And there is one more pass called Tinker Pass, which is under the control of Nepal. And there is one more pass called Dipi Adura Pass, which is also right now controlled by India, which is north of this Kutiyanti River. Kutiyanti River coming from the west, and Kalapani River coming from the northeast, and the Tinker River coming from southeast. They all join at a particular point, and India says that only after this, this can be called as Kali River. Beyond that, this Treaty of Sagoli doesn't apply, because it says that all areas west of Kali River are India and east of Kali River is Nepal. Nepal has never accepted this. So after this 1816 treaty was signed and British army took over this Kalapani area, Nepal sent people to represent their grievances, and they say that traditionally Kalapani, the streams coming down from the Kalapani is considered as Kali, and therefore this should be the boundary, and the areas east, southeast of Kalapani River should be assigned to Nepal. So this area, this is around 35 square kilometers. So they said that Kalapani is the real Kali River. If you say that Kali River is the boundary, so this area should be given to Nepal. British also initially agreed and transferred this area. Later Nepal sent another representation saying that this Kutiyanti River is the real Kali River, and therefore this whole area also should be part of Nepal, which the British didn't agree. But this was transferred to Nepal, there is no doubt about that. But once 1857 happened, and then 1860, the new Governor General, they didn't agree what East India Company agreed, and retook the Kalapani area. The British retook the Kalapani area, and what is the present day boundary was, what's the product of 1860, not 1816 Sagauli, 1860, after the British directly took over the administration of India. As you said, the Nepali kings never accepted this interpretation that Kalapani area belongs to India and not to Nepal. So this has been a simmering dispute. And Lipule Pass, this area is known as Bayans Valley, because the name of the ethnic group which is living in this area is called Bayans group. They practice transhumance, which they move, the winter pastures are different and summertime pastures are different. They move their animals to the southern areas during winter and all that. So Lipule Pass has been the traditionally an important pass for trading with Tibet. Later, most of the trade moved to the Tinker Pass under the control of Nepal. So there was no problem. Of course, after independence, India also signed a treaty with the 1950 Treaty of Peace and Friendship, where we decided that whatever outstanding disputes, border disputes, will be resolved through bilateral negotiations. The issue was 1962, Indo-China War. After that, India closed the Lipule Pass. Because of fear of Chinese entering the Indian heartland through the passes in Himalayas, India closed the Lipule Pass. But in 97, the India reopened the Lipule Pass, and through which Kailash Manasarovar Yatra. Kailash is not very far away. It's somewhere here, another 50-60 kilometers, you will find the Mount Kailash and Manasarovar Lake. So that time there are no proper roads. So the road ended Indian side, this is in Pitorkar district in Kumayun Hills. The road ended at Dipule, that is much further south. Then you have to trek all the way to Lipule Pass. There are around 5-day trek. People have to walk and then go into the Tibet side. Now what happened was, last year India published a map, official map, showing Lipule Pass as part of India. That time officially Nepal made a protest to India. So on now in May 8th, India, Rajnath Singh, through teleconference, opened a new road which India has constructed, which will go very close to Lipule Pass for the benefit of the yatris, because Lipule Pass has been completely damaged during the 2015 Nepal earthquake. After that, the traditional route for the Kailash Manasarovar Yatra has been shifted through Sikkim, Nathula Pass, because China has built beautiful roads from Tibet to Tibet. So now India has on May 8, 2020 has opened a new road from Dachula to Lupule Pass. Now only 5 kilometers you have to trek to go into the Tibetan side. So to make much more easier for the travelers, you know, now thousands of people are every year going to Kailash Manasarovar Yatra. So now it has triggered the fresh controversy. Now the Nepal says that this is their territory, the whole Kalapani territory, and 2 days back has published a map. Previously they were climbing only 35 square kilometers of area between the Tinker River and Kalapani River. Now with the new map published 2 days back, they have gone back to the original demand which they made to British. They have shown all this area including Limpi Adura Pass as part of Nepalese territory. It is now around 330 square kilometers. From 35 square kilometers, the climbs have now increased 10 times to 330 square kilometers. Of course, India has rejected this. They saying that the present road lies completely in the Indian territory and artificially Nepal is expanding its territories and all that. In fact, but there have been belligerent noises have been made on both the sides. Of course, the India's Nepal policy in the last 5 years has been nothing short of a complete disaster. The present government in India believes in an Akhanda Bharat and Hindu Rashtra. Nepal is a Hindu country. So it's very surprising that such the relations have gone such a low. The genesis of this can be traced back to the 2016. And the Nepal passed a new constitution in 2015. And the present Indian government was completely against it. So they imposed an informal blockade on Nepal, which caused huge distress to the people of Nepal. There are very, very strong anti-India feelings arose during that time. India officially denies there is an blockade, but everything, vegetables, all essential commodities, even cooking gas, even petrol, everything was going from India. And they said that Indian truckers are not going there because they are afraid to go to Nepal because of the political problems there. So whatever may be the reason, the blockade which continued for almost 3 months caused huge anti-India feelings, and at that time there was a pro-India government in Kathmandu. It was led by Nepali Congress, which is traditionally pro-India. Maybe the present Indian government thought that Congress Mukt India also included Nepal. So they didn't want Nepali Congress rule there. But from a pro-India friendly government, because of the strong anti-India feelings aroused because of this blockade, Communist Party came to power in Nepal in the 2018 elections, the first elections based on the new constitution. So with a resounding majority, 175 seats out of 275, almost two-thirds majority. So therefore now the RA also cannot buy MPs in Nepal to change the government there. The present ruling government in India tries, always buys the opposition MLAs to change governments in various states in India. That is also not possible with the huge majority enjoyed by the communist government there. So Mr. Oli, who is became the prime minister after that, has taken a very strong pro-China line. And Xi Jinping has visited Nepal. They have signed a lot of agreements. Now they have signed an alternative, now China is providing hydrocarbons. They are planning to lay even railway line into Kathmandu Valley. I posted a lot of videos on Facebook regarding that and all that. So we have made an enemy out of Nepal. There was absolutely no reason for that. So it's a complete disaster. So I've been talking about this Kalapani issue after India opened Lipule Pass for this Kailash Manasarovar Yatra in 97. Definitely that time itself Nepal protested, but that time the protests were not as vehement as present time. But officially they did protest, and since 1998 onwards we have set up a boundary commission and we have been talking periodically to resolve peacefully the Kalapani issue. So this issue has been there since 1816. It is of course another baggage of the colonial era. But the independent India has not taken any measure to resolve such outstanding disputes with the smaller neighbors, whether it is Bangladesh or Bhutan or Nepal. This is unfortunate. we have taken a big brother attitude, that, you know, might is right kind of an attitude. But things have changed because China has become a very powerful country, and it is lending support indirectly though to all the smaller neighbors, whether it is Maldives or Sri Lanka or Nepal, or even to some extent Pakistan also falls in this category. So this won't work, this powerful show won't work. We need to talk to the smaller neighbors. I've been always saying for the past 15-20 years in my class that we should be magnanimous with smaller neighbors. We should have resolved it. We should have, you know, 10-15 years back, we should have said, okay, we accept that Kalapani is your area. Nothing wrong. It's a small area, 35 square kilometers area. Officially, the sovereignty will belong to you, but you will sign a simultaneous agreement by which 999 years you give it on to India. India will, because of the strategic importance of Lipule Pass, we want to control that. So we could have easily resolved that, giving up the sovereignty, but at the same time not giving up the control, physical control, military control of the strategically important Lipule Pass. So we didn't do that. We allowed the time to pass. So the stronger country always thinks that, you know, it doesn't take things, you know, very seriously. The same thing happens with India-China border talks also. There is no proper, you know, demarcated border between India and China. That's why we went for a war also in 1962. But China is not interested in settling the boundary because it thinks that it is a stronger country, and therefore there's no need for any giving up any territory. But the history is not like that, because history, even the small powerless people suddenly get powerful friends, and they immediately change the tone. That's what is happening right now to Nepal. Instead of climbing only the 35 square kilometers, now they are climbing 335 square kilometers, 10 time increase. So things, we have allowed things to such come to such a pass. I'm not here referring to Lipule Pass or to Limpi Yadura Pass. So creative diplomacy is a need of the hour. Instead of, you know, trumping up nationalism on either side of Kali River, that is not going to help. You know, I always say that hope that, you know, better sense should always prevail. But as things happened in 2016, the foolish thing which happened, the blockade, we completely destroyed the Indo-Nepal relationship, and the same things are continuing right now also.